Hello, my name is Michael Kaler, and I am the lab manager of the GYM Diffraction Facility, located at the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. This video will show you how to perform a gonio experiment using the XYZ stage. This is the shorter video that covers only the basics for those who have already been trained but need a reminder on how to perform the measurements. Here we see the Empyrean system set up with the XYZ stage. In order to absorb some of those X-rays, we will use an attenuator. If we want to install the attenuator, we want to align it like this, and then place it just to the left of the solar slit. It just goes all the way in and sits there pretty loosely. Also, for alignment purposes, we want to use the smallest divergence slit possible, which is 1/32. Remember that the anti-scatter slit should be 2 times whatever the divergence slit is. So this needs to be 1/16 of a degree. I believe right now I have 1/2 degree in there, so I will change that out for the 1/16. Remember, just push all the way in and pull back until it clicks. And those are all of the changes for the incident beam side. For the diffracted beam side and for alignment, we want the programmable anti-scatter slit to be as open as possible, so we will use the computer to set it to be 4 degrees. The recommendation I received from Panalytical is to remove the large solar slit on the diffracted beam side. Honestly, I have tried it both ways, with and without the solar slit, and I don't really see any difference. You should see somewhere on your screen right now a comparison of 2 patterns that I collected with and without these solar slits. Officially, you should probably remove it, but I'm just going to leave them in there as that is one less thing I have to worry about remembering to put back in. Other than that, there isn't really anything physically that you need to change on the diffracted beam side. The first thing that I like to do before I forget is to align the sample in X and Y. X is left to right in the sample chamber, Y is front to back, and Z is up and down. In the GYM diffraction facility, we have an alignment camera placed above the sample. In order to access that, we go to Tools and choose Alignment Camera. Let me make this a little bit bigger and left-click Start. Here we see our sample. The crosshairs show you where the center of the X-ray beam is. I'm a little off-center. You can see that I am currently at the 0, 0 position. If I right-click, I can choose Move Stage to this position, and now you will see the sample shift. Now it is better centered. For this sample, I just want to perform phase identification, so I don't really care if the beam falls off of my sample, so this is good enough for me. I will left-click Stop, and then I will close this window. Here we see 3 tabs, Instrument Settings, Incident Beam Optics, and Diffracted Beam Optics. This first tab, you may or may not even need to do anything with this. What I am going to show you here in this video is how to perform alignments using a batch program that carries out all of these steps for you. I have created another video that shows you how to make this batch program, and if you would like to view that, just click the link that should be appearing at the top right of your screen. Now let's come over here to Incident Beam Optics. I will double click. I get this window. In here, we can tell the computer what hardware we have installed for the incident beam optics. I will go through each of these tabs one by one. The prefix module is the programmable divergence slit. That's good. For alignment, the divergence slit should be 1/32. The anti-scatter slit should be 2 times what the divergence slit is. And if you recall from earlier in this video, we changed it to be 1/16. I have a 10mm mask installed, so that's fine. You don't need to change the distance to sample. You'll notice that when I click the top row, it becomes the bottom row. Beam knife, I'm not using one, so that's none. Solar slit, I have the 0.4 radian. I have a filter, but it is on the diffracted beam side, so for this side, it is none. If you recall, we installed the beam attenuator earlier, so I will left-click and choose the copper point 1. Then I will choose Do Not Switch for Usage and Activated. Mirror, that's also none. I will left-click OK. This window just tells me to make the physical changes in the system that I said I did in these tabs. I changed this, so I can left-click OK. Because it is so important that you insert the beam attenuator, it is reminding me to do that in a separate window. As long as you have done this, you can go ahead and click OK, but make sure you put the attenuator in. I can't stress that enough. Let's go to Diffracted Beam Optics and double-click. The prefix module, there we have our detector and the programmable anti-scatter slit, or pass, so that's good. For alignment, we want our anti-scatter slit to be as large as possible, so I will choose 4 degrees. We don't have a receiving slit. We have the nickel filter that gets rid of the beta radiation. On this side, we don't have a beam attenuator. For the detector, these are the settings we use for measuring your sample. But for alignment, we want to change this to receiving slit 0D. I will highlight this and change it to 0.1 and hit Tab on the keyboard. We see that it becomes 0.165 and changes to 3 active channels. Collimator, none. Solar slit is the large 04. And mask is none. I will click OK. Wait for the changes to be made and the window to close. And now, just a personal preference, I like to left click instrument settings so that I can watch these values change. I will go to Measure, Program. Here I have the file that I want to run. You see that it is a general batch. If you need to, you can click Browse and find your program wherever it is on your computer. This is the one that I want to use though, so I will open it. Here we see that I am not saving any of these scans. I don't have to worry about file name settings or anything. I will just click OK. Now we see that no program is executing, and we see that our angles are all zero. We will now go back to the chamber and switch our optics to our measurement optics. We need to remove the attenuator. If you forget to do that, you will most likely get no signal when you try to collect your data. We will also change back the anti-scatter slit to whatever we want to use for our measurements. I'm going to use a 1/4 degree divergence slit, so I will change the anti-scatter slit to 1/2. And that is all we need to change manually on the incident beam side. On the diffracted beam side, nothing needs to be manually changed unless you removed the solar slit for alignment. If you did that, reinsert it before making your measurements. Now that the optics have been changed, let's announce the changes in the computer. Incident beam optics, I will double click. I still like to go through every tab, even if I didn't change anything for that tab, just to make sure I don't forget something. For divergence slit, I'm going to use 1/4 of a degree. If you use something different, then change it to whatever you want. My anti-scatter slit is then 1/2. Mask, that's still 10 millimeters. I still don't have a beam knife. Solar slit didn't change. Filter didn't change. I removed the beam attenuator, so I need to change this to none. And the mirror didn't change. I will click OK. I did these things, so I will click OK. For diffracted beam optics, I didn't manually change anything. Maybe you removed and reinserted the solar slits. But even if you didn't do that, you still need to come here and make a couple of changes. Prefix module is still pass. Anti-scatter slit should now equal your divergence slit, so for me that's 1/4. Still no receiving slit. I still have the filter in there. No beam attenuator. For detector, I want to change this back to scanning line detector 1D, and it should automatically fill in this number and give you 255 channels. Collimator none. Solar slits, here I'm just going to leave this. If you removed it for alignment and chose none for the alignment step, then you will want to change it back to either 02 or 04, whichever one you were using. I'm choosing the 04. And mask is still none. I will click OK. Now that all of our optics and tabs are set up correctly, I am ready to either make a program or measure a program to collect my data. I will just go to Measure, Program. Let me navigate to my YouTube folder. Programs. And this is the one I want. Nope. XYZ stage. It should be this one. I will double click. I will click the folder icon here to choose where I want to save it. I'll put it in my data folder, and I'll just name this YouTube example. You can name it whatever you like. Click Save, and then OK. I'll close this. Let me take this opportunity to ask you to please like, comment, subscribe to our channel. Anything that you can do really helps us out. It encourages YouTube to show our videos to more people who can benefit from them. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. Otherwise, thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great day.